The Aquamax Eco Pump range is specifically designed to power filtration systems and waterfalls or watercourses. The Aquamax Eco Pumps feature an innovative servo motor, which results in energy savings of 40% compared to traditional pumps. Not only are the resulting power savings beneficial to the environment, but also to you financially. The Aquamax Eco 12,000 and 16,000 also feature seasonal flow control, which alters the flow rate and power consumption of the pump depending on the water temperature. This can result in additional savings of up to 20% on running costs. The flow rate is automatically reduced in colder periods when a higher flow rate is not necessary, particularly when running a filter system. The seasonal flow control can be switched off to give a uniform pump performance, ideal if you are running a watercourse or waterfall. The strainer has a large surface area, giving longer maintenance periods. The pumps are capable of pumping solid particles of up to 10 millimeters in diameter, ideal for removing these particles from the pond and passing them to an external filter system. The solids handling capabilities help to ensure exceptionally low maintenance requirements on the Aquamax Eco Pumps. The Aquamax Eco Pumps also feature an adjustable second inlet, which can be used to draw water from a skimmer or a satellite strainer to increase pond water circulation. The Aquamax Eco range can be used submersed in the pond or dry installed below the water surface level. The pumps are supplied with a swivel hose connection, which facilitates easy hose placement in the pond. OASA grants a 5-year request guarantee on the range for added peace of mind. Installation. Firstly, remove all packaging and read the instruction manual carefully to familiarize yourself with the product and the accessories. For the Aquamax Eco 12,000 and 16,000, you should decide whether the seasonal flow control should be switched on or off prior to installation. Depress the engagement clips at the front of the strainer casing and open the casing. Select the desired seasonal flow control setting on the slide. Then close the casing, taking care to route the cable correctly. Cut down the stepped hose tail to the correct size, depending on the hose diameter you are using. Push the hose tail through the retaining nut, then push onto the hose and secure with a hose clip. Insert the O-ring into the retaining nut, then screw onto the pump outlet. If you are using a skimmer or satellite strainer, follow this procedure to connect the skimmer or satellite strainer to the second inlet once the blanking cap is removed. Select the desired inlet flow using the graded setting on the inlet distributor. Setting 0 means the pump will only draw through the main strainer casing. Setting 4 means the pump will only draw from the second inlet. If you are not using a skimmer or satellite strainer, ensure the inlet setting is at position 0 and the blanking cap is fitted to the second inlet. Rotate the outlet hose tail so that the hose will be routed correctly in the pond. And tighten the retaining nut to secure in position. Then carefully place the Aquamax into the pond in the desired position. Ensure the hose is connected to a filter if required, or to the top of a waterfall. If the pump is to be dry installed, remove the pump from the strainer casing and remove the second inlet connections. Cut down the shorter stepped hose tail to the desired size and push through the retaining nut. Insert the white flat gasket into the retaining nut, then screw onto the inlet thread. Connect to the inlet pipework and ensure the pump is mounted horizontally below the water surface level. Connect the power supply and check for operation. Check for leaks at the filter or the top of the waterfall to avoid any water loss. Always consult a qualified electrician when installing any electrical equipment in your garden. And remember to disconnect the power supply before entering the water or performing any maintenance tasks on your pond and pond equipment. Maintenance. Before performing any maintenance on your pond equipment, always disconnect the power supply prior to commencing any work. Carefully remove the Aquamax from the water, taking care not to pull the electrical cable. Unscrew the hose tail from the front of the pump and the second inlet if being used. Then place the pump on a flat, clean surface. Depress the engagement clips at the front of the strainer casing and open the casing. Remove the pump from the casing and clean the casing using clean water and a soft brush. Remove the second inlet fittings from the inlet of the pump. Clean the impeller vanes using clean water and a soft brush. And check the impeller spins freely. Remove any blockages. Replace the second inlet fittings onto the inlet of the pump and replace the pump into the strainer casing. Close the casing, taking care to route the cable correctly. Reconnect the outlet hose tail and any connections for the second inlet. Then place the pump back into the pond. Connect the power supply and check for operation.